Hi guys, so this is a little miscellaneous collection of words that I've just sort of, in editing the text to stick in the description box underneath. So to remember that there's all the words that we've spoken about in the description box underneath. In editing that, I was like, I don't think I spoke about that one. I don't think I spoke about that one. Because I wanted this to be like a reasonably, you know, well-collated little collection of this stuff. I might even have another extension video as and when these things go on. So the bulk of the work is obviously in the sections that we've spoken about, but this will just be like really little add-on videos if I come across any great terminology and I think, I've not spoken about that. So, yep, right. So let's have a little look at the list that's on my sheet called Forgotten, or Forgotten to Mention. So yes, I've kind of skirted around a couple of these, but this is mainly for the learners of French as opposed to the dancers that need to know things, okay? So the first thing was we spoke about very briefly, I think it was the first thing we spoke about was à terre, and terre obviously being the word for earth, okay? You know, terrestrial in all this business we use in English. I just forgot to say where else that word is really useful, and I think it's actually part and parcel of a really important idea that you should be thinking about in your French developmentally as well. So we said that if you were kind of quite advanced in your French, that you should be thinking about when you get a word, or particularly a verb, you should be thinking, how can I make that verb reflexive and how can I make it figurative? You know, how can I use it in a non-literal way? Another category of work you should be really sort of quite getting into is trying to find words where the your original word is then embellished or has something placed either side of it to then turn it into a verb of transformation or a verb which pertains to your original word. In other words, if you say, for example, said long, how would you make lengthen? If you had wide, how would you make widen? If you had white, how would you make whiten? So for example, white, blanc, to whiten, blanchir, we're adding an ending. Red, rouge, to go red, rougir, I went red, j'ai rougi. Some of these are great and really useful. Now, those of you who are a little bit more advanced will know that to make something an adjective, we use rendre. Luc makes me happy, alors Luc me rend heureux. But, and not fair, but sometimes if it's a physical quality, a physical transformation, this is very, very useful work. So for example, we've already spoken about long, long becoming allongé, lengthen. So terre has two that I can think of. One is to land. So if you're going to the earth, atterrir. So the landing of a plane, l'atterrissage. Yeah, ils ont atterri, they've landed, all right? The second one would be enterrer. So in, earth, and then ER on the end. So they've both got terre in the middle. You don't want your plane to bury into the soil, you want it to land. So enterrer is to bury, yeah? L'enterrement is the burial, okay? L'enterrement. So whilst those two words are really useful, enterrer, l'enterrement, and atterrir, atterrissage, those two ideas, it's more about right. Make sure that you think about that. If you come across an adjective, joli, pretty, to make pretty, enjolivé. Yeah, black, noir, to blacken, noircir. Yeah, so that's quite representative of quite an important thing to be doing anyway. Not really of massive interest for our friends in dance wanting to practice their French pronunciation, but very useful for our friends in French wanting to learn words from ballet. The next one I wanted to talk about was tour. I think I spoke very briefly about tour and I don't think I spoke about it enough. So tour, okay, is... So, the dance usage of tour is, obviously we have tourner, to turn. So tourner is to turn, you know, and we'll talk about that in just a second, you know. In the dance, we've had détourner, when we spoke about our kind of like turning back on ourselves and unturning and deviation and going away from where we were originally turning or turning away from where we were originally going. So it wasn't so much to disturn. If you remember, we spoke that de meant un. It wasn't so much to disturn, to unturn, if that makes sense. It was more using the action of the turn to dis or get away or whatever it is from something else. So we'll speak about tourner a little bit more in just a moment, but the noun of tourner is a tour. So you guys will have come across this in dance as like, oh, a double tour or a tour en l'air. We say tour like tour, T-O-R, like tour, but it's tour, tour. We've once again got this O-U, tour. So again, are you going to spend your life going, oh, you know, he did a great double tour. A tour en l'air, you know, you can refer to a tour generally as in a type of tour, but at different turns. But generally when you say like tour en l'air, double tour, you're talking about the action of quite simply when you jump up in the air, quite a male, well, no, not exclusively, but often in Grand Allegro, men will have this at the end of a combination when women might be doing something else. So when you basically are, you're in your cross position, that you're in your fifth position there, or no, or wherever you are. Yeah, your legs in front. Yeah, you're going to jump from there. And as you go up, you're going to turn around, often change the leg position, and you're going to land. So you're basically turning like this, your body, and you're landing, okay? Normally two, to sort of look quite beautiful. So turn, 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 turning. None of the retiré position we spoke about, although you can, yeah? You know, you can do all kinds of interesting things. You can have one leg in the retiré position. You can do all your saut de basque, which we spoke about, the basque step earlier. You can do a turn away from where we're going and that other leg come round and follow you around in that lovely retiré position. There's loads of ways to turn in place, moving away from where you are, legs together, one leg up, both legs up even at one point. You know, so all of that can happen. Turn both legs, then both legs split. You can turn however you want in ballet, but the general usage of tour, most commonly, or double tour, will be this. So let's have a little look at where we would use these words in French, because tour is sneaky. First and foremost, un tour is masculine. Yeah, nothing to do with the dance step being male, but or more male, I shouldn't say that. Un tour, as opposed to une tour, which is a tower. So some of you might have heard of the Eiffel Tower. So basically, if you said the turn, le tour, it's my turn, c'est mon tour. Yeah, my turn. Yeah, à moi, mon tour, it's my turn. La tour is the tower. Same word, different gender, means something different. Okay, so la tour is tower. In chess, yeah, your rook, your castle, yeah, because it's like a little tower, isn't it? Tour de France, you might have come across the cyclists' event, yeah, with the gilets jaunes, like the, you know, the maillot jaune, like the gilets jaunes is the workers that strike in France every weekend. The maillot jaune, like the yellow jersey that you wear, that the winner of that section wears, you know, at the end. So, yeah. Tour is going round something, so it becomes part of the word. So autour de, autour de, autour de, around, preposition. So around, you know, autour de moi. We have entourage, entourage, Mariah and her 25 people. I don't really have an entourage. No. So entourage, somebody that you are surrounded by, you know, the people that go out with you. A single turn, a rotation, yeah, a tour, yeah, to turn, j'ai fait demi-tour. Now, demi we spoke about earlier with half, yeah, so to turn around like I was just talking, and then, pardon my just at the shower here, banana, going with something new, Umberto Gianni. The brand, yeah, banana conditioner. Yeah, we'll see what it looks like when it's dry. Tour, demi-tour, faire demi-tour in French would be to just turn round. So I heard a noise behind me. Alors j'ai entendu un bruit. Derrière moi. Yeah, notice derrière, not en arrière. J'ai entendu un bruit derrière. J'ai fait demi-tour. Okay, lovely. Not to confuse you, but can I remind French learners that we have the addition of one of our return verbs. So when you have retourner, obviously, that is one of the ways. So return, that you can return something else in French, very much so. But if you were using it with yourself, like I went back, to remind you, that is one of our reflexive formats. So I went back, and you know, I've spoken at length about the difference between them, between je suis rentré, kind of more going home. Je suis revenu, I kind of came back to the point that I was kind of in. This is very basic, there's lots of variations within this. Or, you know, je suis retourné, like I went, you know, again, I kind of came back. Really, I returned. But they're all reflexive. They're all etroverbs. They're all etroverbs. All right. So that was tour. I felt tour needed talking about. Okay. My turn as well. Yeah, mon tour. Lovely. Forgotten. Oh, yeah. Air. So we spoke about, you know, à terre, and then we spoke about, you know, en l'air, meaning a position for like where your leg is, whether it's like on the ground or in the air. But air itself, I don't think I spoke about enough. So air has a lot of qualities in French that I really, really like. The first thing is, it obviously does mean air, like the air that we breathe and we were all blessed to breathe, that we need to look after. The second thing is air is very commonly used for seeming. So, oh, Luke seems happy. Il a l'air, plus adjective. Now, this is grammatically a bit interesting. So if you said, for example, so Luke is male. So if you said, alors, Luke, il a l'air content. Let's come up with a female name. I have no idea why, but Daphne came to mind. And I've not even been watching Scooby-Doo. Let's go with Daphne. Let's go with Daphne. Okay. It's really interesting. Some first names, people go, oh, does that exist in France? And I'm like, well, yeah, because these things are kind of from Greek and whatever, aren't they? So they're not always as common. Certain ones take off. But jokingly, like people go, oh, does that name exist in France? And you're like, yeah, it's kind of not British. But let's say we went with Daphne. I don't know where the heck Daphne's come from. So she seems happy. Elle a l'air contente. So even though the basic word for air is masculine, when you use it to mean seem, you will make it gender appropriate. So yeah, so he seems happy. Il a l'air content. She seems happy. Elle a l'air contente. It will take the gender of the person that's got that, you know, that's seeming like that, which is a bit nuts, isn't it, for French. Good. Now, the next word, I can't believe I forgot this one. This is so obvious because in my mind, it's just such a common word. So this will surprise you, but bar. So first pronunciation, bar, bar, okay? So as in the bar in French, bar in ballet, guys, it obviously refers to the physical bar and your period at the bar, as in the time that you spend at the bar. So you'll often refer to like a floor bar. May you never be injured, dancers, fingers crossed. But, well, no, floor bar's not just if you're injured, it's just great if you are. So your bar, okay, it's la barre, okay? So can we firstly talk about the fact that it is B-A-R-R-E and not bar, which is kind of like drink. I'm not being ungrateful, but I mentioned in one video that I liked a little bit of di Serono in a coffee occasionally at Christmas, and I've been sent by really grateful, like Luke, thank you so much for the videos, really sweetly, three people send me a di Serono bottle. I've got di Serono coming out my pores and it's quite sweet, so I don't like to, you know, so anybody that stumbles across the di Serono video, di Serono, anybody that stumbles across that, thank you, but I'm all right. I'm good. Thank you very, very much indeed. There's other things. If you wanted to get me something, go on the coffee account underneath. By all means, just purchase me a single coffee. That will do. So bar, as opposed to a bar where you'd go and drink. So firstly, a bar where you drink would be masculine, because we go au bar, and it would be the word, it would be masculine. So to the bar, au bar. La bar is the feminine bar that you, you know, like a piece, a long bowl, a long pole, piece of wood, metal, whatever, that is a bar, all right? So let's be really, really careful. And that is, you know, that is used quite a lot. Like, so for example, to call somebody to witness to the bar, we often talk about in American legal system, you know, like being, you know, well, and British as well, but, you know, called to the bar and all this business as a barrister as well, not a barista, as in people that make the coffee. But basically, that in French would be, if you were called to the bar, as in to present, like where you'd hold the thing and, you know, and testify, that obviously would be à la barre, you know, appelé à la barre. Like an ache, like a strong, again, dancers, maybe it's never happened to you. You've got like a strong ache specifically in your back. You know, you can have une barre, you know, dans le dos. To pass an amount, to pass the bar, like, you know, like you talk in English about raise the bar, you know, it's really raise the bar. But if you think of it as like a threshold, or you think of it as a line, a point at which you're going to pass. So you could say, for example, the value of the pound has gone above, not at the moment. but if you sort of said the value of the pound has kind of, you know, gone, you know, has passed, you know, then that would be like passing la barre and all this as well. Anything else with barre that's quite useful? Barré. Don't know what I think about this. Ils ont barré la route. Ils ont barré la route. They've barred the road. Like basically, they've closed the road. Yeah, super common word. I don't like to use mental health terminology wrongly and a bit spitefully. I was with a paranoid schizophrenic for a long, long time. I don't know. It's not good, is it, to throw around certain terms, because it's like mental health is important, particularly male mental health. I'm not saying female mental health isn't important, but this whole thing, guys, we can talk feelings. But what was I going to say? It is another one of the many words in French that we use for insane. So, il est, enfin, il est barge, il est barré, il est taré, il est dingue, il est fou, il est ouf. There's a lot, okay? I sort of feel that if you're using these words lightly, meaning, oh God, your behaviours, whatever, rather than a way to call somebody who has a defined and self, you know, not self-diagnosed, but who stated that they're mentally ill, you wouldn't use those words, would you? But even again, the use of saying they are mentally ill, we all have mental health the way we have physical health, don't we? We have times when we're feeling great and chipper and grand and whatever. So anyway, I don't like using those words, but that is one of the other words for nuts. You know, barré, but not as common. Sanglé, barge, taré, you know, much more common. Great, so that's barre, okay? Anything else? Cross out, I suppose, yeah. Yeah, j'ai barré. You know, like if you've got a word and you go shh with your pen, barré, like a line through it. Yeah, put a line, like a bar through it, okay? Se barrer. Oh my God, why didn't I even remember se barrer? Se barrer, another one to like go away, so, you know, partir, s'en aller. Yeah, il se barrer. Yeah, a reflexive verb to clear off. Good grief, I forget how much we use this word, because it's coming from, steer a boat as well, because you're turning the metal thing to barrer, yeah? So, very useful word. I'm glad we looked at bar. Are you? Lovely. Lock, we've spoken about. That's all fine. Good. You know, like, you know, put a bar across, barre. Lovely. All right, so bar. Good. I've got de côté down, but I'm trying to think why I've got de côté down, because I'm sure we spoke about à côté de côté, to the side, rather than next. Maybe I think it was just à côté de is next to where you are, and de côté is related to where you are, that your movement is being done just to the side. So a little bit again like devant as opposed to en avant. So I'm here, my leg is going devant me, I'm going to fall forward, tomber en avant. My leg is going behind me, derrière. My leg goes behind. This banana smells great. It's taking a long time to dry, but it does smell nice. My leg is behind me, but if I were to fall backwards, tomber en arrière. It's a little bit the same with à côté and de côté. So for example, à côté de moi is like next to me, but I'm just going to put something de côté, like, you know, from where I am to just there. So a similarity there, okay? I've got en tournant written down, en tournant. Now, the reason I've got en tournant is if you do something en tournant in ballet, you are basically turning. So, in other words, it is a movement that you don't have to always do as a turn, but you are choosing to do it turning. Okay? So, I don't know, like an assemblé en tournant, you know, jeter, you know, jeter en tournant, whatever, loads of things, okay? If you can do it, if you can leave the ground and you can land, if you're leaving the ground, what better opportunity than to fly? Yeah, you know, like to turn around and do all of this stuff. So, yes. So, en tournant, in turning, en tournant. So I just wanted to speak about this ANT business, just for a couple of reasons. So firstly, ANT is known as the gerund, the ing form of a verb. So it's often confusing to beginners who read, and you know I'm not a massive fan of people visualising verbs, I'd rather they get the sound, because you look at a basic verb, so for example, je parle, tu parles, il parle, nous parlons, vous parlez, il parle, we look at those verbs, and the they form is ENT, P-A-R-L-E-N-T. And then you come across ANT, and ENT is silent, silent. Did you see what I did there? Silent. And ANT, we pronounce. There's a couple of times ENT would be pronounced, like, I'm sure ardent in French is A-R-D-E-N-T. Yes, like a raging burden, burning, ardent. Yeah, or lent, for example, lent, slow, obviously, slow, lent. Yeah. Ardent, lent. So, but as a verb then, ENT as an ending is silent. So they speak, ils parlent, they eat, ils mangent, ENT, ENT, ENT. But ANT is an ing, and an ing in French is pronounced en. So in turning, en tournant. So just more for the English, for the French learners rather than for the dancers, wanted, I mean, en tournant, non, non, not nose. I just wanted to make sure that you knew this grammar. So when you use ing in, and I've done a video on ing, so will somebody who watches this please write underneath, Luke, post your video on ing. Or you could just go to my YouTube channel, which you're obviously already on, go to my video list, type ing, and this video will come up. But basically, ing is used so much more in French than, in English, pardon me, than it's used in English. So first things first, we use it for continuous tenses in English. I am speaking right now. How would we say that in French? Je parle. I speak, je parle. I am speaking. Je parle. I was eating. Je mangeais. I used to eat. Je mangeais. We don't have an I was. We don't say j'étais mangeant or je suis mangeant. So we don't use it for the continuous tenses, which is a massive, massive, massive subtraction because we use that so much in English. Next up, we can use it with the verb to be. So you will hear je suis something something en when it's an adjective. So for example, I am motivating, je suis motivant. I'm stimulating, je suis stimulant. You know, I am motivating my students by telling them to, if it were a verb, je motive. Yeah, you can't say je suis motivant. So number one bane of my life when teaching the was tense, that all of you still want to use ing. I was talking to, no, not j'étais parlant, je parlais. So be careful to not overuse ANT, ing, generally. Where else do we get rid of it? Before going to, you know, church, ballet class, which is a lot of people's church, avant d'aller, we use di and de, and we then use the infinitive, avant d'aller. After going, après être allé, before eating, avant de manger, before of to eat. After eating, après avoir mangé. Okay, so we don't use ing in all of these things. When do we use ing then? So you can, as demonstrated in en tournant, have in speaking to Luke, I discovered, what random fact. Lovely Phil, whom I mentioned at the end of the fourth video when I said, right, if anybody wants to go and do some great, great ballet classes in London, I'll often tell a story and he'll go, God, your life is so random. So, yeah. So, but if you go in speaking to, and do you know what? Very, very randomly and quickly, whenever I teach one-to-one, so you sometimes see group classes on here, but it's not the same as my one-to-one individually, which I don't record. I always use that person's life or my life for the vocabulary, I can't say to speak English. Because it just generates a nice cross-section of words. It's really, really interesting. But people go, Luke, you've got such a random life and such weird crap keeps happening to you. So, yeah. But if you were saying, in speaking to Luke, I discovered that he loves his garden. I do. I love my garden. Anybody wants to come and see it, let me know. We'll go and have a look. I do. It's looking really, really good. My hydrangeas are still out in force. Yeah, looking great. So if I said a tour de force, by the way, yeah, if you did something which was like an impressive piece, tour de force, do you remember tour? So if I said in speaking to Luke, you can say en parlant, okay? He did it whilst doing this. You can say en and then the ing as well, you know? He did it whilst, you know, driving. Alors, il le fait en conduisant, you know. But lorsqu'il conduisait would be slightly more common, you know. Or quand il conduisait, when he was driving. So whilst and when, you know. Or while and when, if you're, you know, certain Americans prefer while rather than whilst. So, yes. Yeah, so, in other words, know of the ANT, but be mindful of it. Where else? Forgotten? Yeah, I'll probably do another one of these videos, but very quickly, the final thing I wanted to talk about was placement. So placement, placement, like where you are, notice the M-E-N-T as well, like the action of doing something. So épaulement, so what you're doing with your shoulders, your placement, you know, développement, the developing. So when we talk about the ing that we've just left, ment is kind of like an ing, M-E-N-T as well. Because it's the act of doing that kind of thing. That's very much an act of doing it. So equally, if you think about it, and quite curiously, M-E-N-T, French learners, is also what makes an adjective an adverb very commonly. So for example, if you said slow, lent, slowly, lentement, normal, normal, normalement, normalement, final, final, finalement. So M-E-N-T has quite an interesting thing. Now this word, this M-E-N-T, it's Latin origin, because if you think of Spanish and Italian, you've got these mente words on, you know, on the end of things, you know, lentamente and all of this. So it's not from French exclusively. But placement, placement, word in English, sort of where you are, what you're doing, all of this. I just wanted to talk about place really quickly. So sur place, as opposed to, you know, en place and à sa place, all of this business as well. So first things first, place versus endroit, versus, what's the other place word I'm thinking about? My students will be going nuts because they know exactly what I'm about. Place versus endroit versus lieu, okay? L-I-U. So generally, if an object is in its place, like could you just pop the forks back in, you know, whatever, whatever, you know, where they go, that would be the place, okay? So the word place there would be very commonly used for smaller things when they have a place where they belong, where they go. So as opposed to a place, that word will also be used for like a place at university or two places on a, you know, public transport or something, or, you know, could you just save my place? That'd be my place. You know, he got a place, place, à sa place. Often, you know, used like a public area, you know, like a square kind of thing. But if you were talking about generically, like, oh, I found a really good place last night that did Mexican food with whatever, 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 then that would be an endroit, E-N-D-R-O-I-T. Yeah, so, and notice with that word, if you say nice place, un bel endroit, because even though it's endroit masculine, it begins with a vowel, so B-E-L, bel endroit. Then if you had, for example, so, oh my gosh, there's this best place. Oh, I'm looking for a place, you know, like a physical larger space that does something else. Oh, there's this great place. My trousers are a bit big. I sort of say, oh, there's a really good place by the bridge in West Hampstead. Nam's Heel Bar. Yeah, Nam's Heel Bar. And they do alterations. So if I say, oh yeah, there's a really good place by the bridge in West Hampstead, you know, she'll alter it for you. She's amazing. An endroit, all right? If you use lieu, L-I-E-U, which is a kind of older word, that is very commonly used. So first off, in place of, like instead, au lieu de, to the place of olhudas. So instead of eating, so instead of using my old shampoo, I use the banana one. Olya, it is taking a long time to dry, isn't it? Yeah, I'm getting a bit bored of the long, long hair at the moment. But every time I threaten where's the London voice come? Oh, every time I threaten cutting it, every time I threaten to cut it, a lot of people get really upset. And then a lot of other people clap their hands together with joy. So, if I say, instead of eating Mexican last night, I ate whatever, something else, au lieu de, to take place, avoir lieu. So the meeting took place, alors la réunion a eu lieu, the meeting will take place, la réunion aura lieu, will take place. So we've got place, endroit, un lieu, all right? In its place, à sa place. Everything's in its place, à sa place. That could also kind of be like en place as well. But if you're sort of using, you know, sur place, rather than en place, so sur place would kind of suggest like, en place would kind of be to do the place it belongs a little bit. Sur place would kind of be to like where you are without moving kind of thing. A bit. You know. Yeah, that's how my heart kind of feels about it. You know, sur place. So for example, if you were talking about takeaway food or takeout in America, in French, that would be, c'est emporter sur, manger sur place. So are you going to take it away or are you going to eat it in place? Okay. So yeah. So finally, ballet dancers, we'll talk about place if you're not moving anything or, you know, whatever, your placement of where you are, whatever, you're well, bien placé, you're placed, whatever. More like a kind of mise en scène, more like a kind of staging, blocking kind of word per se, rather than a move, but you will come across it. But yeah, so there you go. So if any more come up, I'll add them. I'll do another little subsequent video. I might not even do a big title screen. I might just literally ping them on as an attachment to the end of this series. But I just wanted to talk about a couple of these things. Good. I hope this was interesting and relevant. Same as normal. Okay. If you were interested in doing any of the ballet, I hope you've seen the previous video number 4 on this topic, which has got the recommendations at the end. If you are, you know, if you found this series useful, please do remember there's a Ko-fi link underneath in the description box. If you are interested in purchasing my podcasts, then please email me in the address which is provided underneath in the description. Please do click like, please do subscribe. Thank you very much. Keep dancing, those of you that are dancing, and keep learning French, those of you that are learning French. Take care.